a negative feedback, another very common network motif. X activates Z through Y, but Z inhibits X. Negative feedback makes a system monostable. That means the system will have one stable steady state. This property is just opposite of bistability that we have seen earlier. Those were positive feedback motifs. Bistability in gene regulation amplifies the stochastic variation in gene expression and creates bimodal population. You have seen that. But negative feedback reduces cell-to-cell variation and generates a unimodal population around the stable steady state. Like an incoherent feedforward, negative feedback also generates transient response for a sustained input and acts as an adaptive motif. But these are all about steady state behavior. A negative feedback can also do something unique. It can generate oscillation. Like stable steady state and homeostasis, stable oscillation is also very important in biology. Think about oscillation of cyclins during cell cycle, or a circadian clock, or even the cyclic change in our hormone levels. These are all stable oscillation and involve some sort of negative feedback. In this video, we will learn about oscillation generated through a negative feedback. This is a negative feedback. X inhibits itself indirectly through Y and Z. What if it inhibits itself directly? That would be the most reduced negative feedback. And that has a name. It is called negative autoregulation, or NAR. NAR are very frequent in transcriptional circuit. Let's model these using ODEs. Here is our model. We are using an inverse Hill function for inhibition. It is a simple ODE, but still make some assumption to make it simpler. Assume X binds to its promoter with a very high affinity. So K must be much smaller than X. Get rid of K from the denominator. And we get the reduced ODE dx dt equal to beta K divided by X minus alpha X. You can easily do the integration to solve this ODE. The solution is X equal to square root of beta k divided by alpha into 1 minus e to the power minus 2 alpha t. I have considered some numerical values for beta, k and alpha and plotted the solution. So initially there is a fast rise and eventually the system reaches a steady state beta k divided by alpha. In this case, I have considered the values in such a way that this steady state value reaches 1. So there is no oscillation. But is not a negative feedback supposed to give an oscillation? Will this NAR give oscillation for any other parameter value? We can answer this question simply by checking the ODE. This is an one-dimensional autonomous ODE. So dx dt is independent of time. To have oscillation, the arrows in the direction field has to change with time. But here, along the time axis, the arrows are parallel. No one-dimensional autonomous ODE can generate oscillation. In NAR, there are two opposing processes, production and degradation. And they are balancing each other and taking us to a steady state. You can break that balance by introducing a time delay between these two opposing processes. One way to achieve the time delay is to include intermediate molecules. So here we have a negative feedback with three molecules. X inhibits Y, Y inhibits Z, Z inhibits expression of X. This is called a repressilator. Repressilators are created using genetic engineering and they show oscillation. Let us make an ODE-based model for this. To make the model more realistic and also to increase the intermediates in our model, I will consider transcription and translation as separate processes. So here we have the ODEs for X. MX is the mRNA of X. X is the protein itself. One ODE for transcription, the other one for translation. Same for Y and Z. So our model has 6 ODEs. Note that the model is symmetric and the parameter values are identical for 3 proteins. So their behavior should be same. I have done a numerical analysis using JSIM. At t equal to 0, all the molecules were 0. And we have got a stable steady state, no oscillation. This is true even when I took a different initial value for all molecules. As long as they had the same level at t equal to 0, the model has no oscillation. So everything is getting balanced and we are reaching a steady state. We need to disturb that balance. Here is a simulation with an unbalanced system. At t equal to 0, x is equal to 1, but everything else is 0. And the reticillator justifies its name. We have oscillation. X, y and z has same type of oscillation, but with a time delay or phase separation. Notice the pattern of oscillation. Initially, the oscillation is unstable with low amplitude, but eventually it settles for periodic oscillation with a fixed amplitude. We can see that more clearly in the phase plane plot. I have shown the trajectory here. Initially, the trajectory is spiral. But finally, it settles for a closed trajectory marked by the brown arrow. This type of oscillation is called limit cycle oscillation. A limit cycle is a closed trajectory in the phase space such that at least one other trajectory spirals into it as time approaches positive or negative infinity. Like a steady state, a limit cycle can be stable. For a stable limit cycle, all the neighboring trajectory approaches the limit cycle with time. Similarly, we have unstable limit cycle and semi-stable limit cycle. Our reticillator has stable limit cycle. We will not go into further details of limit cycle oscillation, but you should know that limit cycle oscillation is observed in many common biological processes like glycolysis or the rhythm of heart. Now we get back to our reticillator. N is the Hill coefficient in our model. I had considered N equal to 3 and we got the limit cycle oscillation. But with lower N, say N equal to 1, the oscillation disappears and the system has stable steady state. Now Hill coefficient is a proxy of cooperativity. So high cooperativity or a sharp sigmoidal non-linearity is required to have oscillation in this system. You can actually modulate the cooperativity by changing the promoter sequence. So a mutation in promoter can destroy oscillation. Now we check the effect of stability of mRNA and protein on this oscillation. K4 is the rate constant for degradation of protein. K2 is the same for mRNA. I define beta as K4 by K2. So beta is the ratio of average lifetime of mRNA to the average lifetime of protein. In my simulation, beta is equal to 0.1. So proteins are more stable than mRNAs. And we have oscillation. Now I reduce protein stability and make them equally stable. So now beta is equal to 1 and the reticillator does not oscillate. By now you must have realized that our reticillator has bifurcation for both beta and Hill coefficient. The system can have either a stable steady state or a stable limit cycle oscillation depending upon the value of these parameters. You may try to explore this phenomena further, but I will leave it here. Here are the key points of this video. A negative feedback will lead to a stable steady state or stable oscillation. It can generate a transient response, act as an adaptive motive, or reduces cell-to-cell variability. Time delay is crucial to have oscillation. Time delay can be achieved when there are multiple intermediates. A reticillator shows stable limit cycle oscillation. Limit cycle oscillation has a closed trajectory such that at least one other trajectory spirals into it with time. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching.